phone call comes from upstairs on the intercom. And Ginger called down, and is anybody down there? So Al is right here. So she hands the phone to Al Strada. She says, Al, come upstairs. Elvis is fainted. Al runs upstairs. It's me. He says, Joe, come up here. I need you right away. So I ran upstairs. I go into the bathroom, and I see Elvis on the floor. I picked the phone and called the operator. They didn't have 911 at that time. And Al got a hold of Dr. Nick. He was on his way to Graceland. The ambulance finally showed up. And it seemed forever, and I found out later, it was like 20 minutes before they got there. We got him in the ambulance. Dr. Nick pulled up. He jumped out of his car, jumped in the back of the ambulance, and it was Charlie Hodge, Dr. Nick, and myself went to the hospital with Elvis.
When I got there, they were putting him in the ambulance. Joe told me that when he went up there that he turned Elvis over, and when he turned him over, that he heard some air move, and I thought that if this was, you know, if this was true, then there was a possibility that something may have just happened, and that we ought to try to resuscitate him. I should have realized, as stiff as he was, and that he'd been for some time.
Dr. Nick was trying to talk to Elvis, you know, stay, hang in there, and he had the, whatever that bottle is with the oxygen over his mouth, hoping that could revive him. We're talking to him. And we get to the hospital real quick, the Baptist Hospital. Got there, and the emergency room people were waiting for us when we got there. Rushed him into the emergency room. I tell you, it was tough. And 30 minutes later, about 30 minutes, I would think, the doctor came into the room, and he said, Elvis has left. Elvis is gone.